Last episode didn't quite go to plan. Today we have the second leg of the Champions League game, which if you didn't see, you should go and watch now, especially if you like watching me be upset and angry at Football Manager. I was both by the end of last episode. We have to turn around our fortunes today. We have PSG in the Champions League, Napoli in the league, and well, we all know what has to happen in this second leg. Having lost 3-0, we've got to try and turn it around in our own back garden. I just don't see how this is going to happen. Let's see how we get on. How's it going, folks? And welcome back to episode number 34 of, Part to Prem. This isn't Park to Prem. This is the Atalanta Let's Play. I'm just excited about next year's Park to Prem, apparently. I hope you're doing better than me. I hope that that's not an omen for this episode. We have to turn up today because last time out, it was not good enough. Now, since last episode, only 4 matches played. The good news, all wins. The not so good news, they weren't all that convincing. We kicked things off with a 5-1 win against Verona. I consider that quite a convincing result. The game against Fiorentina, though, somewhat less so. Knew that we needed to rotate our team. Our fixture schedule was really, really rammed for kind of the last month, and it's still a little bit busy into the foreseeable future, even if we don't make it out the Champions League. So B team played this game against Fiorentina. Wasn't as plain sailing as I'd like, but we did just about scrape by, in the end, a 5-3 win. And off the back of that, we got off to a really, really good start in the Italian Cup semi-final. We won 4-0 against Torino. Things you love to see. Yeah, the Italian Cup, it's not a competition I have fond memories of. It's not a competition we've yet won. I'm hoping that this year is going to be different. We look good after the first leg of the semi-final. I mean, just as a little reminder, if we go to the... I want to go to the final. How do I get to the final? Help me. I promise I do actually play this game. If we just look at the previous years, obviously, lost on penalties to Lazio, lost 3-1 to Inter. The year before that, we didn't make it to the final, so we don't have to worry about it. But if we were to go on now and lose 3 finals in a row in this, I don't know what, I'd scream. Maybe not in the video, but I would scream just into my pillow at night as I cry myself to sleep. What an image. Anyway, after that Torino result, we did win our most recent game in Serie A. 4-1, a good performance, a rotated 11. Luka getting on the score sheet again. 5 goals and 4 assists in the rotated 11. He's kind of given me food for thought. Food for thought that maybe I should be playing him a little bit more. I feel like last season he was a bit... A bit meh. This year he's not quite been as good as I was hoping he could be. I mean, 9 goals in 17 isn't bad, don't get me wrong. But when you compare it to Sesko, who has 17 goals in 16, and you compare it to Raspadori, who has 15 in 15, naturally, Luka just isn't quite performing to that same standard. But, and I don't want to put him down too soon, he is starting to get to that level. Now today, as well as that PSG game, we are going to do a game against Napoli. It's a game which with, 10 games left of the season? If we win, we would go 9 points clear of them and put ourselves in an immense position to win the league for a third year in a row. Truth be told, the teams who were really breathing down our necks, the likes of Roma, who were right up there at one point, Inter as well, have just dropped off the pace a little bit, and no one's really been able to keep up with our consistency. I feel like first half of the season, the better teams always seem to do quite well in Italy. The second half of the year, as the schedule gets, well, as you can see here, pretty busy through January into February and beyond, it just feels like other teams don't have the same depth and the same rotation that we do. I think that is one advantage you have as a human player in Football Manager, your ability to kind of plan ahead a little bit more. It's definitely served us well. It leaves us in a good position where, well, a win today against Napoli probably secures us the Serie A title. I don't want to promise anything too soon because last episode, just I'm fragile still from it. Assume nothing, prepare for the worst. Should we go play PSG? So PSG at home. We lost the first leg 3-0. We need a little bit of a miracle to turn it around. But when I look at our team, I do genuinely think that we could win this game 3-0 or 4-0. I feel like we do have the potential to do that if we play to our very best. Looking at Raspadori, looking at Sesko, we have to create more in this game. I do feel like home and away advantage is pretty significant in Football Manager. That said, we already know the kind of team that PSG possess. Even in our own back garden, this one isn't going to be easy. We're playing our best possible 11. There's no injuries to speak of. There's no major concerns. As for their team, Messi, Neymar, Mbappe all start. Let's do this. Of course, this is only the first knockout round of the Champions League. This is meant to be where you get an easier game, especially if you win the group like we did. it's not really how it's panned out. Of course, last game we did struggle, I feel like, to create against PSG. I do look at their system with the five at the back and the two centre mids in question. You know, if we really struggle, maybe after 40 minutes of this game, certainly by half time, we might have to change things quite radically. But I don't feel like we've hit a wall yet as a team. You know, we've not gone into a game where we've just not been able to create anything across two legs. I mean, the early signs here are terrific. 26 minutes played, 8 shots, 4 on target, 55% of the ball. Bad news, there's not been a single highlight. I swear if we get through the entire first half without a highlight, I am going to be unamused. Anything, Football Manager? I was about to say no, but there might be a chance here. Sesko, okay, we'll take that. A goal right before halftime, 20 seconds over the extra time that was originally given. We'll take it. We won't complain. Yes, it's a set piece. Yes, it's a ratty near post corner goal. I'm the king of the rats, if that's ratty. It's 1-0. I don't really want to change anything at halftime all of a sudden. I wouldn't have been saying that 20 seconds ago. But with that goal there, we put our noses ahead. I'm going to tell the players I'm delighted and to keep up. Look how positive they all feel. I do look at Raspadori on a 6.6 and question it, but I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt. We need 2 more goals to stand a chance. We need to ideally not concede, although away goals obviously no longer a thing in the Champions League. And you know what? I've been patient. I'm going to make the change. Luka on for Raspadori. Elsewhere, am I going to do it this soon? I am going to do it this soon. I'm going to move Zach Hyen to play as a shadow striker with Tonali and Almada either side. This is a change I have done in games which we're chasing throughout the year with, well, mixed success. But I feel like without a defensive mid, maybe we can make them pay and, well, maybe we'll just score another corner. It's 2-0. Sesko's got both goals. Tonali's got 2 assists. I do feel like now having Zach Hyen play as a centre attacking mid, especially against a team that don't have a CDM, we might be able to create a little bit more. And well, it's not pretty, it's not sexy, but it is 2-0. We've only had 5 corners to their 4. We've made 2 of them count. And with what, 16 minutes left? We need more. So far, all the highlights have just been set pieces, which isn't really good enough for us, to be honest. We need to, we'll try and get the ball forward a little more frequently. I'm going to change our wingers to be on attack. We've got to be a bit more, I suppose, attacking and aggressive in terms of how we play here. I do want to keep the passing directness on standard, but I'm going to push the tempo up. And out of possession, I am going to ask the players just to push that little bit more. We really need another goal. And with 16 minutes left, there's not a whole lot of time to do it. I'm not going completely gung-ho tactically yet. I say that. There's now 5 minutes left. Can I pause the game? Thank you, Football Manager. We've got, what, 2 minutes here to get a goal. It feels unlikely, I'll be honest. I feel like we've left it too little too late. But let's throw men forward. I've still got subs. I mean, we've been the better team in this game. We've just not created enough. I'm going to bring in Pessina for Almada. Play Zach Hyen on the right. I mean, can I get much more attacking than this? I suppose I can move Scalvini into into centre mid. He can actually play there. DeMarco's not really a natural left attacking mid player, but I think he's the best we can go with. Yeah, I feel like I've given it everything I can here. I am gonna keep on Tonali, actually. Let me undo that. I'm umming and ahhing. I'm gonna keep on Tonali. I'm gonna take off Scalvini and I'm gonna bring in Rovella to play as a centre mid on attack. I mean, can you tell we're getting desperate? There's been so few highlights in this game. Often in this kind of match, there's just a load of highlights, right? You know the deal. Like, there's all those highlights. There's a load happening. That's just not been the case in this game. Nothing has really happened. Try and force opposition in wide. We have 2 minutes to make something happen here. The tactical changes haven't happened yet, and there is now a highlight. And it is in our favour. I mean, if we get a goal, I'm going to have to cancel everything. Have we got a goal? Is that going to count? Lucas scored. It's 3-0. Is it going to count? It's not going to count. I was scared to celebrate. I just had this feeling. How close was it? He's not... Oh, is he off? He is off. He wasn't in camera shot. Right, 4 minutes. We've thrown everyone forward. I can't go any more attacking. That can't be the game. We can't end our Champions League campaign like this. Except we can. They had 1 shot in the second half. They had 1 shot on target. I don't feel like we played that badly. I know we didn't create anything from open play. I know we were set piece rats. Oh, I just feel so deflated. We don't even get close to winning a Champions League this season. I really thought we had a good chance this year. Club World Cup in the summer, of course. I thought it's entirely possible. Is it entirely possible? Well, the answer is a resounding no. We are rubbish. And I feel sad. I'd be lying if I was to tell you I'm not absolutely gutted about that. It wasn't even close, was it? Well, it was. We had a goal disallowed, but it didn't feel close. There was no highlights. It wasn't a classic Football Manager game. It just felt a bit sad, really. We've got Napoli in 4 days. I'm going to go reset for that. If we beat Napoli, we're in a great spot to win the league. And suddenly this season just has a weird ending where I think next time out we'd come back for the Italian Cup final. And then maybe the end of the league season if it's down to the wire. And then we're straight potentially into another transfer special. I'm not ending things this year. I'm not happy with how this has gone down. I don't know how the transfer special works with the Club World Cup either. I've not thought any of this through. I'm going to go have a think. I'll join you for Napoli. I mean, that was just a weird game. Nothing happened. Nothing. I just feel like we've been robbed of a moment by the game there. Right, we go again. I was hoping I might have the small silver lining of a youth intake today to lift spirits. No, we don't even get that. The youth intake hasn't arrived before this Napoli game. So sadly, we go into this Napoli game knowing we're out of the Champions League. That dream is dead for the year. But on the flip side, a win here, and we won't have mathematically won Serie A, but we'll be in a position where we've all but won it. So that's what we're going to go for. And I want revenge. Last time we played Napoli in the league, I got battered 3-0. I realise we've still got the team selection from the last game, but I can quickly select our preset best 11. And well, here are all our lovely players, all those bottlers who let me down in the last game. You know what? I'm going to give them a second chance here to make amends, to turn it around for the people. Do it for the fans. You lot were shocking yesterday. I was going to say yesterday. It was a few days ago. I've forgotten how to talk. The last few episodes have been tragic. And I'm sad. So let's get to the game. Right, Musa on the far side. Throws it to Tonali. Whipped in by Musa. Raspadori scores a header. Not the player you expect to be in the box scoring that kind of header. I think this is going to count. Musa's celebrating in front of the ref. He's that convinced. It turns out VAR will check it. The goal is given. Why couldn't we have done this last episode? I say last episode, last match. Everything's blurring into one as of late. It is just, the last kind of few episodes, it's just been a tragedy. The whole thing's been a tragedy. Not a comedy, not an entertaining documentary of Atalanta greatness. But at least it's a silver lining start. They've got Vargas on the pitch. My memories, they're coming back about the last time we played them. Vargas, don't do me dirty again. Raspadori gets it, plays it forward to Sesko. Could we have two goals inside 15? No, he's tried to be clever there and he's looking like an idiot. Napoli trying to play the ball out through the midfield here. Now with Depaul, bringing it into wide area. Can we force a turnover in possession? We can't. They get it to Vargas. He got two goals and an assist last time we played them. I remember that bloke. He's someone we have got to try and shut down here. Ball played forward. Vargas on the end of it, hits it. Marco, good little save by the keeper. Gets it away quickly. Can we go up the other end and score? Not this time. Scalvini, though. Free kick just in their half. I'll tell you what. We're not looking as convincing as I'd like as of late, but we do still play spurts of nice football. Unfortunately, defending feels optional at the moment. I say all of that. We did keep a clean sheet against PSG. I'm trying to find a crumb of comfort. Maybe that's the crumb I can take. We shut down Mbappe for a game. Anyway, DiMarco with the ball, plays it into Sesko, through, one-on-one, hits it straight at the keeper. I mean, we're having more chances this game. That last match was over so quickly, wasn't it? I feel like I owe you guys more. I should have told the players beforehand, make sure we have more highlights for this second game. I'll tell you what, they're giving us more highlights. We're 2-0 up. And it's Raspadori again, a man who's been camera shy, not performed well this season when we've been here for episodes. Whenever I go off, stop, hit and record, performs amazingly. But today, he's on for a hat-trick already. Ball played in by Scalvini, volleyed in by Raspadori. That's good. That makes me feel better. Could we get free before half-time? I mean, Pasalic. Is that going to be... Is that the Pasalic who used to play for us, Pasalic? Didn't we sell it? I thought we sold him to Inter. Did we sell him to Inter? We did sell him to Inter. Then they've sold him to Napoli. And he's now been sent off against us. Oh, it's all coming round in circles. I'll tell you what, 2-0 up, they're down a man. This game's done. That doesn't mean I'll be taking off Tonali, Sesko and Almada, though. They're staying on the pitch today. Lesson learned. Even if we get it to 3-0 with them down a man, not taking any chances. Sesko plays it to Raspadori. He's on for the hat-trick. He's not going to get it if he finishes like that. He's tried to chip it too. This entire half just feels like one long highlight. We've had so many of them, we might have it over here. DeMarco on the far side crosses it in. Sesko's under it. Merritt makes a save. Parried out. Rebound is blocked away too. I thought for a second it was going to be a third before halftime. It might still be. Sesko hits it. Merritt makes the save. And I think that is going to be it now. Probably 2-0 to the break. There's 3 minutes plus any added time. We've had opportunities. We've not taken all of them, but I mean, normally I'd be really happy about 2-0 or 3-0, but after the Milan game, I can't even celebrate being 3-0 up, even if Raspadori scores that. Which he hasn't. He has just hit the crossbar, though. What? How many shots have we had this game? We've had 13 shots, a 1.54 XG, apparently. It feels like we've had way more chances than that. There might be another here as well. Raspadori wanders wide, tries to play it to Zakayan. It's dealt with by Napoli, at least for now. They love lumping it forward for our centre-backs to win and then carry forward. Scalvini, not for the first time in this game, bringing the ball out. Gives it to Almada. He's wandering into the channel of space. Gives it back to the wide centre-back. DeMarco dinks it. Zakayan's under it. He volleys it. It's going to be checked by VAR. Zakayan, I feel like, was onside there. It's going to be, well, potentially 3-0 at the break, assuming VAR doesn't chalk it off. It should count. Will it count? No, it won't. Who was offside here? I don't think Zakayan was off. I could be horrifically wrong. I mean, Zakayan wasn't. Raspadori might have been. That's a load of rubbish, that. VAR never rated it. I bet in real life, VAR would never look at the wrong player to draw a line in Serie A. Was it Juventus who had the goal? I think it was Juventus who had the goal disallowed recently where a bloke was offside, but they weren't offside and there was another player that didn't have the line drawn. I've done a topical reference there to something that happened a few weeks ago in real life, then forgotten which team it was. Someone at home will know. You can fill in the blanks for me. Let me know. Right, corner for Napoli to start the half. Vargas is floating it in. I'll tell you what, if they get one back, I will start to panic slightly. I know that what Vargas is capable of, although he's been a bit quieter in this game compared to when we previously played them. Just looking at the ratings across the board, everyone's playing well except Romero at centre-back on a booking. I'm taking him off. We're going to bring in Pepetti to play through the middle. Before that can happen, though, there is going to be a chance here, maybe for someone. Napoli launch the ball forward. Mancini wins it, lays off to Tonali. They've got no centre-attacking mid. They're kind of playing a 4-2-2-1. It's like a 4-2-3-1 without the centre-attacking mid, but it gives Tonali so much time and space on the ball in the middle. He's loving it. I'm loving it. Can we make something happen here? Musa puts in Zakayan with a header on goal. It would have been a good goal if he'd beaten the goalkeeper, although it's one that Merritt always looked pretty comfortable dealing with. Now Napoli going to look to, well, get the ball forward. They lump it clear. Romero wins his header. Might be his last action on the pitch, that header, because we're about to take him off. Zakayan and DeMarco. Little 1-2. DeMarco to Musa. Players queuing up in the middle. Almada's there. And Almada scored. Was I about to take Almada off? If I was, not anymore. Not anymore. Pepetti can come on. Almada was on a 6.5. Never doubted him. Knew he'd always come good. We have got a third goal here. Yes, we bottled it against Milan in this situation. I know you're all thinking it. It's not going to happen again. They're down a man. This game's done. I hope. 24 minutes left on the clock. Marco with the ball in hand. This has been a really convincing performance against Napoli. Of course, they're second in the league. This is meant to be the second best side. Raspadori's on for his hat trick. He's not going to get it because, well, it was offside and he didn't actually score either. But he could still get it. Tonali, corner, whips it in. Scalvini, Raspadori's missed an open. He was offside. He knew he was offside. He missed on purpose. Into the final few minutes of this game, there is no comeback. There is no hope for Napoli. There is no late drama to end this game. It is going to finish 3-0. It was one-way traffic throughout. Scalvini picking up man of the match. Things you love to see. Managed to get an assist. Our former man in Pasalic sent off. Made this game fairly straightforward in the end. And who cares about winning the Champions League anyway? Lots of good teams haven't won a Champions League. We're all about Serie A. Speaking of which, you can see now we are clear at the top. Milan have got a game in hand on us, but they now trail us by 17 points. This gap that we've built up has kind of come out of nowhere. Scalvini, by the way, 13 headers, 103 completed passes. What a bloke. Okay, so as I sit here at the end of this episode, I'm kind of reflecting on what we've experienced with the Champions League this year and how the league's looking. The reality is that we should win the league from this position. We're in such a good spot. With that in mind, and the fact that we're 4-0 up in the first leg of the Italian Cup final, my plan of attack is to come back for the Italian Cup final next episode. We will do an end of season kind of episode of sorts. I don't know if there's going to be anything super high stakes besides the cup final going on, which I think actually happens before the end of the season. But we'll do a little bit of an end of season overview, a recap of the squad, how players are developed, where I'm thinking we might lean in the transfer market. But I'm not sure how I'm going to do the transfer special with the Club World Cup going on. It might be that I try and bundle the two together. It might become like a weird three-part transfer special with matches in between. If I had a plan, I'd sit here and tell you the plan. At the moment, I just don't have one. Either way, we'll leave a little bit of mystery and suspense for the next few episodes, but there will be another season. I'm not bowing out with that season there when I want to win the Champions League. Going out in the first knockout round, not acceptable. Even if it's to PSG, even if it was 3-2 on aggregate, we can do much better than that, and we will do much better than that next season. I'm going to leave things here for today. Thank you for hanging out, as always. I hope you've enjoyed the episode. I'll see you again next time for the Italian Cup final, hopefully, unless we bottle the 4-0 win we got in the first leg against Torino. That's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. We'll be back for the final next time. I'll see you then. Take it easy. It's me, Jack, and I'll talk to you all in a bit. I'm out.